Quando Pietro
when Peter
salì a Gerusalemme,
went to Jerusalem, went up to Jerusalem, the faithful reproached him. They reproached him because he had gone into the home of men who were uncircumcised and ate with the pagans. They couldn't do that. It was considered a sin. The purity of the law did not permit this. But Peter had done it because the Spirit had brought him there. There's always in the church, in the early church, there was a lot of this because they didn't have any experience. There's a spirit that we are those who are right are righteous and others are sinners. It's us and them and divisions. We have the correct position before God. Instead, others, sometimes we say that they're already condemned. This is an illness in the church, a sickness that grows or that is born out of ideologies, out of different religious parties. There were at least four religious parties in the early church, the Pharisees, the Sadducees, the Zealots, and the Essenes, and each one interpreted the law according to the idea that they had about the law. And this idea is a school that's outside of the law, and when there was a worldly spirit, they would interpret it according to the law. Jesus was even reproached for having entered into the house of tax collectors who were sinners, according to them, eating with them, with sinners, because the purity of the law didn't permit this. And he wasn't washing his hands before eating a meal. There was always this there's always this type of reproach that brings division. This is the point that I would like to underline. They are ideas or positions that make divisions, to the point that the most important division happens toward unity. It's my position is more important than the Holy Spirit who guides us. There's a cardinal emeritus who lives here in the Vatican. He's a good shepherd. And he said to his faithful, but the church is like a river, you know? Some are more on this side, others are more on the other side, but what's important is that we're all inside the river. This is the unity of the church. No one outside, everyone inside. And then with the small differences, this doesn't divide. This isn't ideology. It's permitted. But why does the church have this breadth of a river? Well, it's because the Lord wants it this way.
Il Signore nel Vangelo
in the Gospel, the Lord
ci dice,
says to us,
io altre pecore.
And there are other sheep I have that are not of this fold. And these I have to lead as well. They too will listen to my voice, and there will be only one flock and one shepherd. The Lord says, no, I have sheep all over the place, and I am the shepherd of all of them. this everyone in Jesus is very important. Let's think about the parable of the wedding feast, when those who are invited don't want to go. One, because he had bought a field, one who had gotten married. Everyone had their own reason for not going. And the master got angry, and he said, go to the crossroads and bring everyone to the feast. Everyone. Great and small, rich and poor, good and bad, everyone. This everyone is a bit of the Lord's vision, who came for everyone. He died for everyone. But he died even for that person who's made my life impossible. Yes, he died even for that person. And for that thief, yes, even for that person, for everyone. Even for people who don't believe in him or who are in other religions, yes, for everyone he died. I'm not saying we have to proselytize, but he died for everyone. He justified everyone. Here in Rome, there is a woman, a good woman, a professor. Professor Mara, who, when there are difficulties in various things among different parties, she would say, but Christ died for everyone, let's just go ahead with it. With the constructive capability, we only have one Redeemer, one unity. Christ has died for everyone. Instead, the temptation, even Paul suffered from this. I'm from Paul, I'm of Apollo, I'm of this person or that person. And let's think, 50 years ago after the council, the types of division that the church suffered, I think this way, you think that way. Yes, it's okay to think this way, but in the unity of the church, under Jesus the Shepherd. Two things. The reproach of those who reproach Peter for having entered into the house of a pagan, and Jesus, who says, I am the shepherd of all. I am the shepherd of everyone. I am everyone's shepherd. And who says, and there are other sheep I have that are not of this fold. And these I have to lead as well. They too will listen to my voice, and there will be only one flock. And the prayer for the unity of all men and women, so that all men and women, and he had only said men, and then he added women, so that no one is offended, we might have one soul pastor, Jesus, one soul shepherd. May the Lord liberate us from that psychology of division to divide, and may he help us see this aspect of Jesus, this great reality of Jesus, that we are all brothers and sisters in him, and he is the shepherd of everyone. Today the word is everyone, which should accompany us throughout the day.